the rock group Quarter Flash played in small clubs around Portland, Oregon, hoping to make it big. Well, now they're on the verge of stardom if they play their cards right, which in today's music scene means not only having your songs heard, but also having them seen.
I'm going to harden my heart. I'm going to swallow my tears. I'm going to turn and leave you.
The rock group Quarter Flash with their smash hit, Harden My Heart, a song currently number 6 on the charts. We caught up with the group taping the song for a video promo in this vacant warehouse where bandleader Marv Ross explained how they got their first contract.
We had a real good following in the Portland area, and we had a lot of people that were fans that came to see us quite a bit of the time.
Radio was real receptive, and it started going up the charts in Portland. I immediately left for Los Angeles and started shopping the tape. And the buzz that was on the street in LA about the regional success.
Riding on the corner, waiting in the rain, I swear I'll never ever wait again. You gave me a word, the words for you are lies.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is Rindy Ross and Marv Ross from Quarter Flash. This is the album. I'll just show it so it doesn't glare. See? It says Quarter Flash. That's the name of the album, Quarter Flash. Why
yes.
not? It's a new name. What? When were you and why were you and why did you change Seafood Mama? That's three questions in one. Why were you Seafood Mama? I know the lyrics came from an old Fats Waller tune, but...
That's right. It was called Hold Tight. We were Seafood Mama. Marv and I were in that band for about 5 years in the Portland area. And about the time that the band was getting signed, we were also breaking up. And so we changed some personnel and a little bit changed our direction more toward rock and roll, and it seemed fitting to change the name. So we changed the name to Quarter Flash, which is short for an Australian phrase that means one quarter flash and three parts foolish.
I see. Okay, I'll accept that. Now, things are happening very fast, are they not? I mean, you have accelerated. Now, that piece of film or tape we saw was played on Coin, K-O-I-N, like in October,
yes.
2 months ago,
uh-huh.
3 months ago. Has it all been happening since then? Does that have anything to do with it, a television appearance? Or are you just that good and you got to the right agent or what? Well, how's it all going? How's it happening?
Well, that piece of film was shot after the album was done, and I don't think it had all that much influence on the national market because it was only played here in Portland. But it's just that the single Harden My Heart has just really taken off across the nation, and I think that's really the reason why things have happened so fast.
Okay,
for us.
Now, the 45 of Harden My Heart is number 6 in Billboard magazine,
yes.
Right? The album is number 20. Now, that's big stuff. I mean, we all know number 1 to 5 and all. But when you're 6, you're selling some stuff, aren't you?
Yeah, we're real pleased.
You must be. Who's behind you?
Geffen Records.
Geffen?
Yes.
I have never heard of that. But do you have a manager, an agent, somebody that's really got a hold of you and said, I'm taking these kids all away, or what?
Jay Isaac here in Portland, who is a lawyer, mm-hmm. and is now just managing us full-time. And he's helped us so much as far as just making it all happen, as far as getting the record deal and then just polishing.
Okay, the 45 record, the small one, is number 1 on album-oriented radio stations. Which are? Give me one in Portland, an album-oriented station. Is there one?
KGON.
That's album-oriented.
Right, or Kink. They're usually FM stations.
Okay, I'm just going over these notes. I'm very impressed. New Year's Eve, you're appearing at Knott's Berry Farm in California.
Yeah.
You ever been there?
No.
That's big time. I mean, it sounds like a kid show, but that's a pretty big deal down there. Where, you've been on a 14-city
tour.
Where? What cities? Well, Omaha, Peoria?
Well, we started out in St. Louis, St. Louis, Kansas City, Chicago, Detroit, Cleveland, Cincinnati.
So what kind of crowds? What kind of reception?
It was great. We were so amazed.
When you say rock and roll, today it's a punk rock or it's, I don't know what it is. I'm not sure what it is. I don't listen to KGON that much, but, I don't know what they're playing. I'm pretty much KEX Kink Radio. I listen to jazz. I'm sorry to tell you where I am.
Sure.
I hear your record all over, though. What was my question? I was talking to myself.
What kind of rock, I think?
What kind of rock are you?
Yeah.
Are you the new wave? Is that
No. Our music is for rock music is sort of it's not hard rock, but it's not soft rock either. It sort of plays right in the middle of between those two.
Walks the line.
Yeah, it walks the line. There's a little bit of new wave influence on the album, but there's also some music on the album that I would say is influenced by much earlier 70s style of rock and roll too.
You know, I've seen a lot of rock bands on. You know, the Solid Gold you're going to be on, too. I want to mention that in January. You're going to be on American Bandstand January 9th. Entertainment Tonight, January 21st. Is that the weekend version or is that a Monday through Friday version?
I think it's the Monday through Friday
version. Is it?
Yeah. Right.
Okay. Now, this is something your attorney, agent, manager, whatever, he takes care of all that, doesn't he?
Yeah. He
calls up producers and says, listen, I've got a band here, and they're number six in the charts, they're Billboard. And they sign you up like that. Isn't that how it goes?
And there's another agency involved in L.A. So the connections are made between Jay and ICM.
Are you living in a suitcase on the road? Is that the way life is now?
No. This was just our first tour. We've been living here in Portland, and we'll be here for a while, and then we're back on the road.
If you're that successful with album 2 and 3, you can't operate out of Portland, can you?
Sure.
Aren't we just too far away from the rest of the world?
Well, it makes it so that you have to travel to record and tour, which you do anyway. It's so much more comfortable here, though. I don't want to move to L.A.
Have you met any other groups that you've listened to on the radio and now you're meeting them and you're in the same league?
Yeah.
Who have you met?
A few.
And what do they tell you?
Met the players in Loverboy. Who else have we met?
You met Little Richard, which was
Little Richard, yeah, that was
Little
fun.
Little Richard. Wapaloopa. See, hey, I go back, I remember.
Met Sheena Easton.
Sheena Easton.
Yes.
Well, I wouldn't know.
Yeah.
But these are people that have been around and they're telling you things, I suppose. Here's what you ought to do and here's what you shouldn't do and don't let it all go to your head and stay sweet and all that stuff. That's an idealist kind of way to do it. Can you do that? Isn't it a tough life being out there or do you just love it?
Well, it's hard work, but we're having a really good time, and I think that all the people in the band have their feet on the ground, and they know what their priorities are, and I think we'll be all right.
What are albums selling for today? 9-something?
I think List is $8.99 or something.
Yeah, $8.98.
Yeah. And when I was talking before to other guests about albums, Michael Redman, I hear record companies, they're very, very selective when they, you know, they don't just cut an album like they used to for anybody and hope it takes off. They have to have some kind of feeling about it and do some surveys and a lot of market studies, see if you're the group that's going to sell them, make them some bucks. Because these are expensive to make and to sell, of course.
Right.
It's true. It's
right.
A business like anything else. It takes, you know, you have to look into everything you're doing.
Now, this is what? Griffin? What is it?
Geffen.
G-E-F-F-E-N.
Right.
Who else do they have? Are you it?
It's a subsidiary.
It's one of those.
Of Warner Brothers. And they also have... they had the late John Lennon and Elton John and Donna Summer.
Good company you're in.
Very good.
Now, what do they have planned for you? As far as promotional tours or anything? Are they going to send you to the White House or back to Madison Square or someplace? I mean, do you know?
Well, not yet. At this point, we will be doing a tour as the opening act for a band called Loverboy in February and March. And from then, I think it's just touring and getting our faces and our name and the record known as much as possible.
And you're going to have to keep producing, and Marv writes some songs. Do you all write songs in the group, or
no?
Mainly, this is the songwriter.
Marv,
you
got to
keep coming up with the hits.
Yeah, yeah.
You know that, don't you? The pressure's on.
Yeah.
She can sing. Are you known as the lady that sings, the lady that plays the saxophone? You play a couple good saxophones.
I think I'm more known as the lady who plays the saxophone because it's different. Yeah.
Oh. We wish you very all the luck in the
Thank
world.
You.
Terrific to
Thank
have you.
You.
Thank you very much.
Brindy and Marv. You're married, by the way. They're
yes.
My brother and sister, in case you wasn't. Okay. Quarter Flash. Here's the album. Costs $8 or something, and go buy a bunch. We'll be back.